Yes, that's right. The new topic right now is reconciliation and peace teaching.
If you call all the peacemakers
God's sons and daughters, indeed, the reconciling party in conflict is to participate on the work of God. We decide that all the members of his family live in peace with one another. Yet, the work of a peacemaker can be even though he or she tries to be even-handed, demonstrating concern and empathy for both sides, the peacemaker is liable to be attacked and blamed by one side or the other. A peacemaker must therefore be willing to make sacrifices and take risks for peace, even to the extent of sacrificing his life. Reconciliation requires much of the quarreling parties beyond a temporary defeat. It requires genuine forgiveness. Ultimately, it should lead to bonds of love and solidarity between the former enemies. Father Moon teaches us to apply the scriptural ethic to love our enemies. See chapter 13, love your enemy. To reconciling with enemy nations and enemy religions. Number one, subtopic, reconciliation. If you are offering your gift, the altar. And there, remember that your brother has something against you. Leave your gift there before the altar and go. First, be reconciled to your brother, and then come and offer your gift. And from the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verses 23 to 24. Let us have concord with our own people and concord with people who are strangers to us. The divine twin create between us and the strangers a unity of heart. May we unite in our minds, unite in our purposes, and not fight against the divine spirit within us, nor the arm of our fall with the break of day. And this is from Atharva Veda 7.52, verses 1 to 2, Hinduism. Better and more rewarding is God's reward to those who believe and fulfill their dharma, who avoid gross sins and indecencies, and when angered, are willing to forgive. Let evil be rewarded by like evil, but he who forgives and seeks the consolation shall be rewarded by God. True constancy lies in forgiveness and patient forbearance, and is from Quran, Surah 42, verses 36 to 43. If they open and close the enemy, inclined to peace, you incline to it also, and trust in God. And this is again from the Quran, Surah 8, verse 61. The Messenger of Allah said, "Shall I inform you of the best morals of this world and hereafter, to forgive him who oppresses you, to make a bond with him who severs from you, to be kind to him who insults you, and to give it to him who deprives you. This is Hadith from Islam. With malice toward none, with charity for all, with firmness in the right, as God gives us to see the right, let us strive on to finish the work we are in, to bind up the nation's wounds, to care for him who shall have borne the battle, and for his widow and his orphan, to do all which they may achieve and cherish a love and lasting peace among ourselves and with all nations. And this is from Abraham Lincoln, second inaugural address. And now we have the teachings of our father, Reverend Son Myung Moon. You should offer your devotion to the people around you and with a peaceful heart. You should not worship where there is discord, because God is not present where there is discord. Your act of worship can bear fruit when there is goodness. It cannot bear fruit where there is conflict and complaint. That is why, when there is a falling out among brothers, they should first reconcile before making an offering table for their ancestors. And this is from August 11, 1997. And of course, we're now on page 1081. If each side insists, I insist for myself, they can never be reconciled. To achieve the goal of peace, people on both sides need to take the stand, I exist for you. When they can come to the point of consoling one another, peace can arise only when we say to our opponent, I am here for you. And this is from a speech on August 1st, 1970. Thus far, nations try to expand their territory by invading others. However, from now on, we should follow the principle that to reach the world, we should deny ourselves. In order for your beloved nation to lead the world, it must go beyond national self-interest. If your nation cannot do this, it does not have the philosophy that can unify the world. And this is from a speech on November 10th, 1969. What kind of world would it be if each nation thought, God is on my side, while it treated other nations as the enemy? It would be a world of continual wars and conflict. To become God's sons and daughters, you have to love the way God loves. You have to love humanity. I know that God wants enemy nations to reconcile, become friendly, connect with each other, and unite to one another. That is why I work to encourage nations to think beyond their borders and form a united world. And this is from a speech on February 25, 1976. And we have the second subtopic, and we have Reverend Ezra here. Peacemaking. Topic number two, peacemaking. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. And this is from the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verses 9. And we read, if two parties of believers fall to fighting, then make peace between them. And if one party of them does wrong to the other, fight that wrongdoer until it returns to the ordinance of God. Then, if it returns, make peace between them justly and act equitably. Lo, God loves the equitable. This is from the book of the Quran, Surah 49, verse 9. He brings together those who are divided. He encourages those who are friendly. He is a peacemaker, a lover of peace, impassioned for peace, a speaker of words that may make of peace. And this is from Dinga Nikaya, 13.75, the Viga Sutta, Buddhism. We read, during the short eons of swords, they meditate on love, introducing the non-violent hundreds of millions of living beings. In the midst of great battles, they remain impartial to both sides, for the witness of great strength delight in reconciliation of conflict. This is from Holy Teaching of Vimalakirti, 8, Buddhism. And we read, Rabbi Guru of Huza often went to marketplace at La Pet. One day the prophet Elijah appeared to him there, and Rabbi Baruga asked him, is there anyone among all these people who will have a share in the world to come? Elijah answered, those two will have a share in the world to come. Rabbi Baruga asked the newcomers, what is your occupation? And on page 1082, they replied, we are clowns. When we see someone who is sad, we cheer him up. When we see two people quarreling, we try to make peace between them. And this is from Talmud, Tanakh 22a, Judaism. And we read, after all the kings had been seated and perfect silence had ensued, Krishna, possessing fine teeth, and having a voice as if a drum, began to speak in order that, O Bharata, peace may be established between the Kauruns and the Pandavas without a slaughter of the heroes. I have come hither. Besides this, O King, I have no other beneficial words to utter. No, O thou of Kuru's race, that those wicked sons of thine, headed by Duryodhana, abandoning both virtue and profit, disregarding morality and deprived of their sense by avarice, are now acting most unrighteous towards their foremost kinsmen. The terrible danger, in bracket, of universal slaughter, thus, close bracket, has its origin in the conduct of the Kurus. If you become indifferent to it, it will then produce a universal slaughter. If, O Bharata, you are willing, you may be able to allay that danger even yet for peace. I think it not difficult of acquisition. The establishment of peace, O King, depends on you and me. Set right yourself, and I will set the Pandavas right. This is from Mahabharata, Hunduga Parva, 95 Hindu. And we read, I have nothing new to teach the world. Truth and unrighteousness are as cold as the hills. All I have done is to try experiments in both on as fast a scale as I could. And this is from Mohandas K. Gandhi, Hinduism. And we are asking the nations of Europe, between whom rivers of blood have flowed, to forget the feud of a thousand years. And this is from Winston Churchill. Now we turn to read the teachings of our two fathers, the Reverend Dr. Sangyen. Antagonism has no place in God's love, only unity and harmony. In light of this, you can understand what the Bible means in saying that peacemakers will be called sons of God. And this is from the way of God's will. And we read, how patient is God, who has been enduring for millions of years? We too need to possess his patience. I am not saying we that should never fight, but there is a right time to fight, when we can fight for the benefit of both sides. We should not fight those who oppose us seeking their destruction. We should fight to educate both sides and bring them together in harmony. We should educate each side to no longer regard the other as the enemy. And this is from a speech given to us March 25th, 1979. And we read, to bring about a united, peaceful world, we must overcome the many challenges arising from differences in religion, race, or in region, race, religion, culture, custom, language, and nationality. If we view the world from the perspective of the Creator, through God's eyes, or through love, we believe that despite all these differences, the world is one. When young people inspired by God's true love dedicate themselves to sacrifice and service, they can begin to solve poverty and hunger throughout the world. They can begin to heal the wounds caused by differences between rich and poor. They can help people overcome the animosities and hatred arising from different historical experiences. To love means to love that which cannot be loved. From this definition, we can acquire a clear sense of direction overcoming relationship of enmity and conflict. And this is a speech given to us November 28, 1997. Turning to page 10, 1083. I have the mission to prevent racial conflict and make peace between races, especially between blacks and whites. The best way to accomplish this is to inspire white people to humble themselves voluntarily and serve black people. And this is a given at February 27, 1983. And we read, black people in America walked a path of slavery, taking the role of Abel as their part in restoration of the heavenly sign. It was black people who established America, not white people. Black people were sacrificed to build this nation. Also, the Indians were sacrificed. You should know that if there were ever a racial war, black people would want revenge, and neither would the other colored If you know that if there were ever a racial war, black people would want revenge, and neither would the other colored races leave the white race alone. Why do you think I, Reverend Moon, came to America? Indians are like my cousins. We are brothers. They are all perishing, and I have to prevent it. I didn't come here to revenge, but to say, I am here to help the races reconcile with each other. Who can reconcile whites and blacks? Can a white person or a black person do it? No, it wouldn't work. Blacks wouldn't listen to a white person, and white wouldn't follow a black person. But black people can listen to someone of the yellow race. Yellow people were also the victim of the white establishment. If yellow people take the lead in forgiving their enemies, white Americans, and tell blacks to do the same, they will listen. A yellow man can teach black people to forgive because their enemy and the Indian enemy is also my enemy. Representing all minorities, I will take the lead in forgiving. I explain them that they are able, and this is Abel's historical path. And this is a speech given to us December 30th, 1979. And indeed, the Congo Christian leaders could not resolve the problem of in the Persian Gulf. So as a safeguard, in bracket, against a full-scale religious war, close bracket, I am convening a dialogue between prominent Christian and Muslim leaders. Most of Koreans would say, what has it got to do with me if Iraqis die or a nuclear bomb falls there? But I know humanity's dismal path, and I want to steer the world to avoid its hidden risk. And even though I am insulted and ridiculed, I am striving to save humanity through diplomatic efforts, even spending my own money. I am trying to get America and the Soviet Union aligned for this purpose. I have also worked for reconciliation between China and Taiwan, and Recently, I began efforts to reconcile Israel and the Arab world. And this is a speech given to us December 30th, 1990. And we read, I have reached the advanced stage of 85 by the Korean way of counting. But I will continue to work harder than anyone else until the day the earth overflows with God's true families. Guns in the Middle East fall silent and give way to fireworks of peace and joy and shouts of Mante, celebrating the unification of my homeland Korea, echoes across the Pacific and are heard in America. This is a speech given to us March 23rd, the year 2004. Now we read subtopic number 3, Jesus sacrificial love as a model for peacemaking. Oh, it's already 5:32. Over to you, Reverend Jones.
as a Christian as well.